स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लास. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्न दैट द डेंसिटी. डू यू रिमेंबर चिल्ड्रन, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डेंसिटी? डेंसिटी इज अ मेजर ऑफ हाउ मच मास ऑफ अ मटेरियल फिट्स इनटू अ गिवन वॉल्यूम. We say density is the ratio of mass to volume. Density is equal to m by v. It means mass by volume. If we have two materials with the same volume, the material with the higher mass will be more dense. It will be have a higher density. Listen this picture. The particle in a solid are tightly packed and cannot be squeezed closer together into a smaller volume. In liquids, they are also very dense. The density of a liquid is roughly the same as the density of the solid state of the same substance. Because their particles are close together, but they are not locked into fixed positions. Most liquids cannot be compressed into smaller volumes. The maximum volume of a liquid that can be stored in a container is called the capacity of the container. It means if the capacity of a bottle is 200 ml, it means that it can be contain any volume of a liquid up to 200 ml. By using measuring containers, we can measure the volume of a liquid. These containers have fixed capacities but different shapes and sizes. Now we can study about different measuring vessels. Measuring cups or measuring jug is a kitchen utensil to measure the volume of liquid or solid cooking ingredients such as flour, sugar, etc. for volumes from about 50 ml upwards. Measuring cups are used to measure washing powder, liquid detergents, etc. The cup will have a scale marked in cups or fractions of a cup. Measuring can is used in ration shops to measure the capacity of a kerosene and vegetable oil. Measuring beakers can be used to make measurements of volumes, volume levels are printed on the side of the beaker such as 50 ml, 100 ml, 200 ml, 500 ml and 1000 ml. They are usually accurate to within 5%. So, a beaker should not be used for accurate volume measurements. Measuring cylinder is a cylindrical glass or plastic jar with markings called graduations. Its range from 10 ml to 1000 ml. This is a common piece of laboratory equipment used to measure the volume of a liquid. When a liquid can be poured into a measuring cylinder, a curve can be seen on the surface of the liquid. This curve is called the meniscus. It can be concave or convex. If it is a concave meniscus, the reading should be taken at the bottom. If it is a convex meniscus, the reading should be taken at the top of the meniscus. The reading should be taken at eye level to avoid the parallax error. Do all the liquids have the same density? Listen, when two substances are in the same container but not mixed, they will form two layers. Water and ice also form two layers. Which layer will be on top? The one which is more dense or the one which is less dense? Another one example, when you mix oil and water as in the picture, the two materials will separate because they do not mix well. When they separate, the oil will always float on top. If a large amount of oil is poured into water, the oil will spread out and form a layer on the surface of the water. For the correct measuring vessel, we have to know the amount of liquid that needs to be measured. Another one is the degree of accuracy with which the volume must be measured. These are the two important points: the amount of liquid that needs to be measured and the degree of accuracy with which the volume must be measured.
Good morning, children. Now we are going to study some numerical questions. Okay, before that we have to know the formula. What is the formula? Conversion between kilogram per meter cube and gram per meter cube. How to write this? Do you know 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram? Okay, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Next, we have to change meter cube into centimeter cube. So 1 meter cube is equal to, we have to write separately, 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter. So we have to multiply these numbers. For 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Do you know 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter? So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter. Okay, well, we have to multiply these three numbers. How we will get this answer? We have to centimeter cube. Okay, see here, 1 meter cube is equal to 100 centimeter cube. Okay, 1 meter cube is equal to, this we have to convert into centimeter cube. Next, 1 kilogram per meter cube. 1 kilogram per meter cube is equal to, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. So we have to write 1000 gram divided by meter cube. Instead of 1 meter cube, we have to write these numbers. So centimeter cube. Okay, we have to cut these 3 zeros. Here also 3 zero. Now how much here? 1 divided by 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, 1 kilogram per meter cube is equal to 1 by 1000 centimeter cube. Again we have to convert these numbers. Listen, 1 kilogram to convert 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, gram per centimeter cube we have to convert into kilogram per meter cube. What we have to do? See here, to convert kilogram per meter cube into gram per meter cube, we have to divide by 1000. Here, to convert gram per centimeter cube to kilogram per meter cube, we have to multiply by 1000. So 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, see, these are the two formulas are very important. Okay, these are the important formulas. 1 kilogram per meter cube is equal to 1/1000 gram per centimeter cube. 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. You have to study these two formulas. Okay. Listen, children. This is the example problem from book page number 30. Okay. This is the example problem. You have to copy these problems in your booklet. First question: a piece of steel has a volume of 4 centimeter cube and a mass of 32 gram. What is its density in question number A, gram per centimeter cube, question number B, kilogram per meter cube. Okay, first one, listen here, what we have to find here, what is its density? We have to find the density. Okay, solution, what is the formula for density? Density is equal to mass by volume. Is it? Density is equal to mass by volume. So here a piece of steel has a volume of 4 centimeter cube. Okay, here volume is given. So volume of piece of steel. How much is 4 centimeter cube? Next one, mass. Mass of piece of steel is equal to mass of piece of steel is equal to 32 gram. 32 gram. What is the formula for density? We have to find the density now. Density is equal to mass by volume. So density is equal to mass. What is the mass? 32 gram divided by volume is 4 centimeter cube. Okay, so how to divide these numbers? 1 4 is 4, 8 4s are 32. Okay, so 8 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, 8 gram per centimeter cube. This is the question A. Okay, the answer is gram per centimeter cube. 8 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, next one, question number B. Listen to the question. Kilogram per meter cube. Already we know this formula. We have to convert kilogram per meter cube. What we have to do? From gram to centimeter cube to kilogram per meter cube, what we have to do? Multiply by 1000 or divide by 1000? Multiply by 1000. So we have to write to convert gram per centimeter cube to kilogram per meter cube, multiply by 1000. So 8 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 8 × 1000 is equal to 8000 kilogram per meter cube. 8000 kilogram per meter cube. First one, a piece of steel has a volume of 4 centimeter cube and a mass of 32 gram. What is the density? Okay, density is equal to mass by volume. Question A, volume of piece of steel is equal to 4 centimeter cube. Mass of piece of steel is equal to 32 gram. So D is equal to, density is equal to mass by volume. 32 by 4 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 8 gram per centimeter cube. We have to convert gram per centimeter cube into kilogram per meter cube, multiply by 1000. So 8 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 8 × 1000 is equal to 8000 kilogram per meter cube. Listen, children. Next question. What is the mass of 5 meter cube of cement of density 3050 kilogram per meter cube? Okay. We have to find the mass. Okay. So, what is the formula for density? Density is equal to mass by volume. What is the formula for mass? Mass is equal to density into volume. Okay, mass is equal to density into volume. What is the density now? Density is equal to 3050 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, next, we have to find the mass, is it? So what is the volume? Volume is equal to 5 meter cube. Now we have to find the mass. Mass is equal to density into volume. So density is equal to 3050 kilogram per meter cube into 5 meter cube. Okay, 5 meter cube. Listen here. We have to write like this. Okay, meter cube. So we have to multiply these numbers. Okay, before that we have to cut these numbers. Meter 3 and meter 3. How much is here? 3050 kilogram into 5. Okay, we have to multiply these numbers. 0 into 5. 0, 5 5s are 25. 0, 2, 3 5s are 15. Okay, so answer is 15,250 kilogram. Okay, what is the mass formula is? Mass is equal to density into volume. Density is equal to 3050 kilogram per meter cube. Volume is equal to 5 meter cube. So the formula mass is equal to density into volume. Okay, before that we have to divide this number, letters. Okay, meter cube, here also meter cube. So we have to cut these numbers, meter cube. Then 3050 kilogram into 5. We have to multiply these numbers. We have to get 15,250 kilogram. Listen here. Next question. This is the exercise question. Page number 40. Okay. Page number 40. Fourth question. The volume of 60 gram of a substance is 20 centimeter cube. If the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube, will the substance sink or float in water? Okay. The density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube is given. Listen, the volume of 60 gram of a substance, this is another one substance, is 20 centimeter cube. So we have to find the density of a substance. Density of water is given. We have to find the density of substance. So density of substance is equal to, what is the formula for density? Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass by volume. So first we have to know the volume and mass. Okay, so mass of the substance, what is the mass? Mass of substance is equal to mass is equal to 60 gram. Okay, 60 gram. Then volume of substance equal to 20 centimeter cube. Now density of substance equal to mass by volume. Mass 60 gram, volume is 20 centimeter cube. Two table here, 3. Okay, so what is the density? 3 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, density of substance is equal to mass by volume. Mass of substance equal to 60 gram. Volume of substance equal to 20 centimeter cube. So 60 gram by 20 centimeter cube. We have to divide these numbers. We will get 3 gram per centimeter cube. This is the density of substance. Listen, here given the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Okay. Density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. What we have to find now? Will the substance sink or float in water? Okay. Listen, the density of substance equal to 3 gram per centimeter cube. Density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. So this is the more denser, this is the less denser. So the substance will sink in the water. Okay. The substance density of substance equal to more, 3 gram. Okay. So the substance will sink in the water. Substance will sink in the water. You should copy these problems in your booklet. Okay, children? Then refer your book lesson 2. Okay, refer your book lesson 2. We will not give the notes. You have to refer all the pages. Okay, children? Thank you.